Okay, so I guess now we're on part three, this particular story. I'm crossing the street a lot because I feel weird talking to a camera in front of people, holding up a camera, walking around. So, basically during all the turmoil and everything of working on the relationship, this was another huge red flag that I kind of was like, you know, I can't tell you, you can't go on this. It's your life, it's your decision. Ultimately, you have to live with yourself if you go out there and do something. And I don't think that you would lie to me if, you know, you're really going to be not doing what I know you're going to go do. So you have to live with yourself, not, you know, with that on your shoulders. So fine, if you're going to go, you're going to go. I'll see how you're acting when you get back. And that was kind of that. Wasn't really excited about it. I pretty much knew at that point that it was over. But, I guess when you're in love, you know, your mind plays some pretty fucked up tricks on you, making you think it's gonna be okay or anything. And, so fast forward to pretty much about, like, the night before she was leaving. We're about to walk by Beta Nightclub, by the way, real quick, so I do a lot of stuff down here in case you guys are wondering what it looks like on the outside. So anyways, I had just bought an APC 40 in my DJ setup, and here's the club. So it's like an old brick building, it's pretty cool. So anyways, I bought this APC 40, and I needed to get a certain couple templates and drivers, and I never used the internet on my music laptop. Because that's a pretty bad idea to be surfing the net and everything on your music laptop. So anyways, I had to load up a browser to look for some drivers for this APC. Oops. And so I load up Mozilla, and I think probably for the first time in maybe like a year, I loaded it up, and her Facebook was logged in to my laptop, and I was like, oh shit, fuck man, don't do it. You know, there was like a piece of me that was saying, just respect her privacy and trust her and all this stuff. But, you know, there was also a piece of me that was saying, you know, you have all these red flags. And, you know, I had some pretty big plans on what I wanted to do with our lives. I wanted to move back to Hawaii, actually. And I was going to bring it with me, and I was going to propose and fucking go down that whole horrible mistake. So all these things in my mind, you know, I'm faced with the decision. I'm like, should I read what's going on? Or, and know, like, what I'm doing is going to be a good decision? Or should I find out? So it was a tough decision, and I said, fuck it, I'll read it. So, yeah, clicked into her messages. Started from the bottom. And, yeah, it was bad. Pretty much, let's see, where am I, 18? Alright, so pretty much the day that I had put, like, no longer in a relationship or whatever, status change. Pretty much, like, the day that happened, this guy just swooped in and messaged her and was like, hey baby, I'm so sorry, like, if you're hurting and stuff, you know, I know you really liked him and all this stuff, blah blah blah, if there's anything I can do, let me know. And then it just snowballed from there. You know, her reply was just atrocious. It was like, oh my god, I'm so glad you messaged me, you know, I've always like had the hots for you, and Trevor was just like a means to get to you, and I'm so, like, have such butterflies that you messaged me, and oh my god, like, I've always wanted to hook up with you and all this shit. And I'm like, what the fuck? You know, so I'm reading and, yeah, it was just, let's see, what would be the best way to say this, yeah, I guess it just kept growing into, like, just nasty shit, you know, like, I want to come there and fucking suck you off, and, like, I want, like, to get a boob job, and he's like, oh, I'll buy you one, and yada, 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 and then they would go over, like, how to cover it up, you know, she'd say, like, oh, I think Trevor's on to me, what do I do, and he would instruct her on how to hide all this shit from me, and, so, yeah, our plan was just to go out there, fuck his brains out, do all kinds of crazy shit, and then just come back, pretend like it never happened. Just gonna cover it up the whole while. And, you know, reading all that shit, I found out that a lot of my other friends were pretty much trying to hook up with her at the same time. So yeah, I called her out on it, you know, I said, this is what happened, I know everything. And, I don't know how you can live with yourself. You know, I sent the guy a message on her profile, or logged in as her profile, and said, hey, dude, you know, I know everything. So you guys don't have to, like, cover it up anymore. And, he never replied or anything. I didn't expect him to. And then she basically said that all that was my fault, that I created this monster in her because I broke her heart by saying that, you know, we were done and everything, and that I didn't love her and all this shit, and, you know, like, I don't really want to get into, like, the details of why we arrived at that point, but I'll just say that my intentions were to get her life squared away, like I had mentioned before. And I took a risk by ending it in hopes that maybe she would take getting her shit together seriously this time, because I'd heard it before endless times. So yeah, anyways, so she went out there, I guess, and now they are engaged. So she went from me of 2 years to engaged with this guy in 8 days. How's that for a fucking kick in the nuts? So I guess I really, that's all I want to say about that, in regards to those two. I mean, he lives like 4,000 miles away, so I don't know what exactly is, how this is going to work for them, but, so yeah, so to kind of loop back around again, that's why Tolkien's gone, because, you know, she was out of the house, her dog was out of the house, Tolkien didn't have anybody to, like, hang out with and stuff, and he was getting pretty depressed. And I basically just said that, you know, to my folks, I think this is the right thing to do, to give him back to you guys. I can't be around to give him the love and attention that he needs, because he's a big dog and he needs to be outside, and so yeah, that's where Tolkien is. I hope that answers the question. I'm terribly sorry that was so long, but I needed to kind of get that out. How am I doing since then? Maybe you're wondering, I don't know, maybe you're sick of hearing me talk. But I've been pretty fucked up, to be honest with you. This whole move to downtown was pretty much a result of that. I kind of said, all right, let's go back to the drawing board. Let's change up everything we can possibly change up. And, hey, look at that good-looking guy. So yeah, I got a loft in downtown. Live in the city now. I'm trying to meet new friends, because all the ones that I had are tied up in her somehow, or mutual friends that I don't care to really associate with anymore, because it's just, it's tough, man. It's tough. It's tough going from somebody you were getting ready to propose to getting cheated on, and now she's engaged with him. I mean, that's tough to stomach. So, taking it day by day, maybe I should get back into making videos. That maybe that would help. Just sort of talk about things, talk things out. And hopefully I have some new adventures ahead in my new concrete jungle. And yeah, there you go. I should cover just about everything. Thanks for listening to my story. Sorry it was me just droning on for a while. I'm sure I left out a lot of details and this and that, but whatever. You get the general gist of it. And we'll see you guys later.